Octopus? Possibly not. Spaceship? Probably yes. Sorry to frighten you. That's the Racal Gemini PIR and ultrasonic combined. One of the first dual techs that was available. Anyway, we've done this one already, but this is the Racal 1012 passive infrared detector. Just looking for a date, and there is no date. I can't see a date on that, but this would have been late 80s, early 90s, certainly not much past that. Used to fit loads of these. Now I've written LR on this because it has a long range lens. Now these would normally have this lens, which is why I scared you with this PIR at the beginning of the clip. So what I could do is I could take that lens off and put it on there, and then this would be a standard 1012 PIR. And I lie to you, because this is a long range, this is actually called a 1025. The 12 means it's 12 meter range, and the 1025 means it's, yes, you've guessed it, 25 meter range. There's a long range lens in the middle. A couple of look down zones there, and does this have the anti-creep? It does. Anti-creep is underneath, looks out of that part there. Now, I don't know if I showed you this part before, but it's a very thin bit of plastic. It's a bit like a paper bag. I used to go to loads of these where the customer would put something through it and would have had to replace the whole front. Now, what can we do with this? This has the zone locator on it. Remember the LED that was above the lens? So if I loosen the lens so I can move it up and down, I can then align the lens with the zone locator LED. Like that, and we can see exactly where that detector will be looking if it is in its normal position. Now as we've moved the lens up, we can see the pyroelectric detector. And what you can't quite see is the LED, which is just above it. Oh yes, that has now enabled the zone locator LED. There it is. So now we can see exactly where that lens is pointing. And I think this could mean that we need to turn the lights off. Oh yes, there we go. The PIR is not looking sideways, it's only looking directly ahead on this one. There, you are looking right in its detection path. So we've got the main, so that will be your zero, and then when you walk into it, it will be your one, and then as you walk out, it'll be a zero, and that will trigger it. If you try to duck underneath it, you're going to get caught by one of these zones. So that would be a 0, 1, 0 as you walk through it. We've got some more down here. So where is this one? Where is this one aiming? There it is. Got one there. And one on that side. And that looks like that's it for that lens. Remember, that looks 25 meters. But not forgetting, you have the ones underneath. Oh, there we go. Look at that. How many segments are on that? We've got one there. So that's the one that looks underneath the detector through that little window there. Oh, nice. And you've got one or two either side of it as well. There we go. I'm going to move the lens back down to its normal position. Turn off the zone locator LED. And just rely on that one for normal alarm activations as it detects motion. Now, before I put it back together again, this PIR in particular was susceptible for spiders coming inside it. So, this one has the silicon on any holes that were in the back, and it obviously would have had silicon around the cable entry hole as well. As it happens, these ones were actually very easy to install. Because you've got a definite side, I mean, if you have a look at some of these detectors, like, for example, this one, that doesn't really have a size. So when you were corner mounting that and you had the corner of the room here, you could, like, kind of not get it quite square. You know what I mean? There's no definite side to it. But these ones were quite nice because if you had the wall, let's have the battery as the wall. There's a corner of your room. You could, you know, you got a definite side to the detector there, and it would be easy to install. But these are quite big. I mean, conventional detector today. Well, probably be smaller than that. Actually, no, there is no detector here which represents the size of a detector today. You can get them probably about half the size of that these days. So this was quite a large detector, and people used to have these in their houses. This was one of the most reliable detectors that Racal Guardall made. So, you know, it's a good detector in its day. I'm still looking for a date. I've still not found one, though. It's actually got an IR1012 on there, but maybe that lens was changed. This is actually a 1025. Anyway, let's not dwell on that. Let's get this thing back together again and do some tests. Unfortunately, I have some really bad news for you. And that is, this Racal IR1025 is faulty. I've left it here for a while now, and that light is just not going to go out. It's a bit of a shame because I used to like fitting these detectors. But nope, yes, it is very sensitive, but I've been sitting on the floor and it's just not going out. Now, I thought maybe it was because there is a latch freeze option on this. So you could connect this up so that if there was quite a lot of these on one zone, which is something you should never do, but back in the 80s, you could have more than one of these detectors on the same circuit. Not a good idea, because if one of them were to give a false alarm, you wouldn't know which one it was. But that's where the latch freeze came in. You could tell the detector when the alarm panel was set, and then the detector that activated would then keep its light on to inform you which one it was. And what we did as standard is we put a little link on which cancelled that feature. But I put that link on and it's still not going out. And another sign that it's faulty is underneath there somewhere is a relay, which then gives you the alarm output, which I think is those two terminals there. And with a PIR, if you keep very quiet and then you wave your hand in front of it, you can normally hear a little tick as the read relay comes to life. Well, actually, it doesn't come to life. It normally stays on, but then it turns off. But you can hear it activating. But this one, I leave it for 30 seconds, wave my hand, no read relay, I can't hear it. So, I'm not spending any more time on it. That is the IR1025